welcome back, and I want to welcome now two guests here today, and I'm so pleased because it makes my heart sad to think that any child or any animal doesn't have a home, a proper place. And Paula Church is here, bless her heart, from Greenville Animal Care. Mm-hmm. And she happened to bring along Princess. And Princess is a wonderful, quiet, gentle little dog. Well, she's not so little either.
No, she's pretty big.
But she's fully grown.
She is.
She's about a year old, and she's looking for a home.
She is.
And you do what at Animal Care?
Well, I'm the community relations coordinator there, and Greenville County Animal Care is the place where you would take an animal, a lost or missing animal. If you found a pet, you could bring it to us, and we would work very hard to try
find
and locate
the home,
the owners.
Oh, okay.
Ideally, we would hold them for 5 days, giving a family plenty of time to come and look for their pet. And if no family steps up to claim them, then they become our property. At that point, we can put them up for adoption.
Try to find a home.
Right.
For them.
And we usually know if somebody hasn't stepped up and claimed them within the first 48 hours, we know they're probably not coming. So, and a lot of our animals do end up coming in as strays. And so we've been very fortunate to be able to find homes for a lot of these animals that that deserve good homes.
And Princess is just looking for somebody to care for her and love her.
She is. She's just as sweet as she can be.
She's a wonderful dog. Now, she's fully grown.
She is. She's fully grown. She's just under a year old, and she is an American Pit Bull Terrier. And she is.
So she's a purebred.
We don't know. We don't have papers on her.
Well, no.
So,
but,
you know, so we have to say a mix. But she's pretty typey for a pit bull. And she's so sweet. You can tell that she's somewhere along the way, she was properly socialized and got some love because she's just as friendly as she can be. She's very curious.
She just walked in the studio and sat down here. We're delighted. Tell me about what are you doing now and what are your needs? And you're helping people help animals.
We are. That's really what we're doing. And right now, we are working hard to make Greenville County a no-kill community. So we want every healthy and happy animal to have a live outcome, to find a home. And we're really successful with that. So we've started a community cat program. We're doing cat TNR. And we're really focusing on limiting the number of animals coming into the shelter by providing resources.
Do you want to sit on the table?
She's gotten very curious all of a sudden, hasn't she?
Yeah. She said, I'm not used to being in a TV studio.
She is looking at everything. Very curious
Here,
little
you
girl.
You get up there if you want to.
There you go,
it's all
sweetie.
Right.
She's,
oh, yes.
All kind, a day of firsts.
Awesome.
But we are trying to limit the number of animals coming in and increasing the number of animals that are going out of the shelter and into homes. So
I think
and that's
she
working
wants
really
to come
well
sit
for
with
us.
Me.
I know, I think I she
think
likes
she
you.
I think she does. Yes. So now tell me what are your needs and what you work with volunteers.
We
I know
do.
You do.
We always need good volunteers. We have great volunteers, and it's the interaction that they have with the animals that give them the enrichment that they need to keep them stress-free and highly adoptable. So they come in and walk our dogs. They
now
help
you
in the
try
cat
to
rooms.
Adopt these animals out.
We do. Yes. Yes. That's
I mean,
the goal.
You're not, a no-kill shelter.
Well, we're working hard to build a no-kill shelter. We're an open admission shelter, which means we take in every animal. We don't turn any
you
away.
You don't turn anybody away.
So, and last year, a typical year for us is usually between 17 and 21,000 animals. And because we've been focusing on limiting the number of animals coming into the shelter, we only took in 12,000 last year. So that seems like a lot.
12,000 in 1 year.
In 1 year. So it seems like a lot, but for us, that was a pretty significant decrease.
And are you trying to find homes? Well, let's take this off.
Yeah.
You're trying to find homes for all these animals. Now, she obviously is a year old, and she needs a yard to run in and maybe some children to play with.
That would be perfect. She seems like she's super friendly. She's good with other animals because we have a new feature in our adoptions lobby at Central Bark, and it's a little fenced-in park area where we can get some of our larger dogs out and they can play with each other. So she was in Central Bark when I brought her today, having a good time romping around with some of the other animals.
So now you have a place where people can go and look at the animals.
We do, yes. We're located at 328 Furman Hall Road, which is back behind Cherrydale. Mm-hmm. And we're open 6 days a week, Monday through Saturday. Yeah. So we're open from noon to 7, Monday through Friday.
And you want to try to find homes for these dogs.
Absolutely.
And you have cats too.
We do. We have cats.
Okay.
And last year we were able to rehome, I think it was close to 9,700 animals.
You just sit down on the couch. She is really full of herself.
Investigating.
She said, I don't know whether I like being on TV or not.
She says, oh, I think she likes it.
Now, so people who think about maybe adopting a pet, as I've said many times, you don't have to go and spend a lot of money and get some purebred creature. Not that there's anything wrong with that, but there are hundreds and hundreds of animals that just want a home.
Absolutely.
Just somebody to care for them.
Absolutely. And she's available for adoption for $35. She's spayed. She's ready to play now.
Yeah.
She's spayed. She's up to date with her vaccines. And she's also microchipped. We think microchipping is a very important thing to do so that people can find their lost animal if they happen to become missing. So it helps us reunite them with their owners. So that's a lot of medical that goes along with the adoption fee of just $35.
So for $35, you get a pet that's already had all
right,
of this. So
exactly.
You don't have to worry about
right. She's completely vetted and ready to go. And you know, for us, it's really a life-saving mission, so we're removing barriers, and we found that there really isn't any correlation between the amount of money that somebody spends on a pet and how well they're going to treat that animal. So I think that when you offer pets for adoption for $35, people realize that it is a life-saving mission and that we need their help, that people need to adopt and do what they can to help provide a good home for animals that are in need of a good home.
It's a wonderful work you do.
Well, thank you.
And you do use volunteers.
We do.
Yeah.
We depend very heavily on our volunteers. We need foster families, so a lot of situations we have an adoption ambassador program where people could come and take a dog like Princess and foster her, and it would become their job to find a home. So we were looking for foster families that are social media savvy, that like to go out, like to go to social places, yappy hours, places
yeah.
that are dog friendly, and give people from the public an opportunity to meet that pet. So we have an itty bitty kitty program where they can foster young kittens until they're large enough to have their spay neuter surgery and be placed up for adoption.
So you need volunteers, people to help not only just to adopt a dog forever mm-hmm. or a pet forever, mm-hmm. but temporary.
Right. Temporary homes, and I think a lot of people say that would just, you know, that it's really hard, you want to keep the pet, but the truth of the matter is you're providing them the care that they need at the time they need it the most. So in most cases, once they can get through the foster period, we can get them into a home. So there's no expectation at all for a foster family to actually result in an adoption. Now, if it does, that's a wonderful thing. We're delighted that
many
that happens.
Many times that does happen.
And it does
I'm
happen.
Sure.
We refer to that as a foster failure when you fail to bring them back to the shelter because they're staying at home with you. But it really is an important service that people can provide for animals.
And if somebody should happen, maybe if you find a pet, maybe, you know, a pet wanders into your yard or mm-hmm. whatever, and there's no identification, you don't know where it belongs,
right.
you accept those animals.
We do. We take the strays, and we have a staff person, and her whole job is to try and locate a missing dog with their owner. So if somebody's missing a pet or if they found a pet, we keep a database and they can go to our website and fill out an online form that gives us the information on the pet that they've either lost or found. And we'll work very, very hard to try and reunite that pet with their owner. So that, last year, I think we had almost 900 animals that came through the shelter that were actually returned to owners.
That's beautiful.
So it's a nice, it's a good day for us when we can find, when we know that there's an owner that's desperately looking for their pet, and we can help facilitate that reconnection.
Yeah. So and I think it's important for people to know you accept animals. If somebody is in some situation mm-hmm. that they can no longer keep this pet, mm-hmm. you accept.
We do. We do accept owner-surrendered animals. We take them all. We don't turn any away. They do have to make an appointment, and our turn-in days are Tuesdays and Thursdays between the hours of noon and 4.
And it's www.greenvillepets.org.
Right. They can go to our website, and pretty much any question that they have, it can be answered through the website.
Okay, and I have the phone number here, but you have a phone number listed. So yeah,
we absolutely. They can get the number off the website. They're welcome to give us a call. If they can't find what they're looking for on the website, they can certainly call, and we'll try to get them the help that they need.
Well, I hope that Princess finds a wonderful home, because she is a gentle, loving creature, and she's been a good guest.
She has been. A little busy, well, but very good, very
sweet.
This is our
wellness, adoption, and a spay and neuter program, animal care, and helping people help animals. I love that. So I'll keep the information here if you didn't get it, but... it's a wonderful work you're doing.
Well, thank you.
And we're delighted to have you here, and we're delighted to have Princess.
Well, thank you so much for having us and giving Princess an opportunity to be seen.
We hope Princess finds a good home. She deserves one.
Oh, I'm sure she will.
And wherever you are, stay happy. We'll see you next time. Goodbye.